Hi, in this video I'm going to explain question number 10 and 11, exercise 6.3, chapter 6, linear inequalities. Question number 10, 3x plus 4y less than or equal to 60, x plus 3y less than or equal to 30, x greater than or equal to 0, y greater than or equal to 0. Here they have given 4 inequalities. Now let us take each inequality one by one and let us find the solution. First we have 3x plus 4y less than or equal to 60. So first convert the given inequality into a equality statement. So we have here 3x plus 4y is equal to 60. Next here, to find the solution for this, we need to take x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. So first let us take x is equal to 0. So if x is 0, we get here 3 into 0 plus 4y is equal to 60. 4y is equal to 60, y is equal to 60 divided by 4, so y is equal to 15. Next, if I put y is equal to 0, then we get 3x plus 4 into 0 is equal to 60, 3x is equal to 60, so x is equal to 60 divided by 3, so x is equal to 20. So now for this equality statement, 3x plus 4y is equal to 60, we have got two solutions. One is x is equal to 0, y is equal to 15, another one is x is equal to 20 and y is equal to 0. Now in the same way, let us take the second inequality, x plus 3y less than or equal to 30. So the first step is convert this into an equality statement. So we have here x plus 3y is equal to 30. Next here, we need to find the solution for this. So take x is equal to 0 here. So we get here 0 plus 3y is equal to 30. 3y is equal to 30. Y is equal to 30 divided by 3. Y is equal to 10. Next here put y is equal to 0, then we get x plus 3 into 0 is equal to 30. So x plus 0 is equal to 30, so x is equal to 30. So now for this equality statement, we have got here two solutions. One is x is equal to 0, y is equal to 10. Another one is x is equal to 30 and y is equal to 0. Next here, let us take the third and fourth inequality statement, that is x greater than or equal to 0, y greater than or equal to 0. Convert both of these into an equality statement, that is x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. Now we can draw the graph for these four inequalities. So to draw the graph, here I have taken a plane which is divided into x-axis as well as y-axis. So first let us consider the first inequality, 3x plus 4y less than or equal to 60. See here we have the points 0, 15 and 20, 0. So 0, 15 means that is this point, 0, 15 means this point, and then we have 20, 0, 20, 0 means this point. So we have got here these two points. So you can combine these two points by drawing a straight line, and here you have to draw a solid straight line because you can see that this is a slack inequality. So I'm using here solid straight line. Next here, so this particular line represents the 3x plus 4y is equal to 60 equality statement. Next, let us take the second inequality, x plus 3y less than or equal to 30. See, for this we have got two solutions. One is 0, 10, another one is 30, 0. So now let us locate these points on the plane. So 0, 10. 0, 10 means this point, then 30, 0 means this point. So now we have got these two points. So join these two points by drawing a straight line. And this straight line is also a solid straight line because here we have x plus 3y less than or equal to 30. So that's why you have to draw a solid straight line. Next here we have x greater than or equal to 0. This is nothing but x is equal to 0. X is equal to 0 means here you have to consider the y axis itself. X value is 0 here for different values of y. So here x is constant and y value may vary. So that's why this itself forms x is equal to 0 line. Next we have y is greater than or equal to 0, that is y is equal to 0. Y is equal to 0 means you have to consider the x axis. Here also y is equal to 0 means y value is constant and x value may vary. So this line represents y is equal to 0. So now we have four lines. The first one is 3x plus 4y is equal to 60. that is this line. Next we have x plus 3y is equal to 30, that is this line. Then we have x is equal to 0, this line, and y is equal to 0, that is this line. So now let us shade the area. The first one we have 3x plus 4y less than or equal to 60. So to shade the area, you have to consider any point. Generally, we take here origin, that is x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. So if I put here these two values in this inequality, then I get here 0 is less than or equal to 60. See, 0 is less than 60, that means it is a true inequality. So this particular line represents 3x plus 4y is equal to 60. And when I took here origin, I got here the value, that is 0 less than or equal to 60, as true. So if the value is true, that means we have to shade the area that is towards the origin. So I have taken this point, and for this point we got true. That means this is the area, that is the area for the inequality 3x plus 4y less than or equal to 60. Next we have x plus 3y less than or equal to 30. Again here also put x equal to 0, y is equal to 0. So we get here 0 less than or equal to 30. See, 0 less than or equal to 30 means this is also true. So we have this line. So here I have taken the point 0, 0, and for this I got true value. That means again we have to shade this area for the line x plus 3y is equal to 30. Next we have x is equal to, that is x is greater than or equal to 0. See, here you can't take x is equal to 0 because that line itself represents 0. So whenever you are checking the inequality values, don't take the line, don't take the point which is located on the line. So x is equal to 0 means it is that line itself. So that's why I'm taking here x is equal to 1. 1 is greater than or equal to 0, that is true. 1 is greater than or equal to 0 is true. That means this line represents x is equal to 0 line. And here I have taken x is equal to 1, and for that we got the value true. That means this particular side represents the inequality x greater than or equal to 0. Next we have y greater than or equal to 0. Again here also don't take y is equal to 0. Instead of that you have to take y is equal to 1, or you can take any point but not 0. Then y is equal to 1 means that is this point, particular point here. So for this we are getting true. That means I have taken some point here. So for that I got true. That means here we have to shade this area. So now see, we have four lines. This particular 3x plus 4y less than or equal to 60 means this side. Then next we have x plus 3y less than or equal to 30 means again this side only. So y is greater than or equal to 0 means again this side. Then we have x is greater than or equal to 0 means this side. So now the common area shared by all these four lines is nothing but this line, this region. So this is the answer for the 10th question. Next year we will see the 11th question. 2x plus y greater than or equal to 4, x plus y less than or equal to 3, 2x minus 3y less than or equal to 6. See, here they have given three inequalities. So first let us take the first inequality, 2x plus y greater than or equal to 4. So convert this inequality into an equality. So we have 2x plus y is equal to 4. Now find the solution of this. So x is equal to 0. If I put here, then I get 2 into 0 plus y is equal to 4. So y is equal to 4. Next, if I put y is equal to 0 here, then I get 2x is equal to 4. So x is equal to 2. So now here for this particular equality statement, we got the solution, that is x is equal to 0, y is equal to 4, and x is equal to 2, and y is equal to 0. Next, again, we have here the second inequality, x plus y greater than or equal to 3. Again, for this also, convert this into an equality statement. So we have here x plus y is equal to 3. Now here, find the solution of this one. So for that reason, just you take x is equal to 0 here. If you put x is equal to 0 in this, we get the y value, that is 3. And put y is equal to 0, then we get the x value, that is 3. So here for this equality statement, we got two solutions. X is equal to 0, y is equal to 3. And x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 0. Next, take the another inequality. 2x minus 3y is greater than or less than or equal to 6. Again, here also convert this one into an equality statement. Equality statement. So we have here 2x minus 3y is equal to 6. Then put x is equal to 0. Then we get 2 into 0 minus 3y is equal to 6. So minus 3y is equal to 6. That is y is equal to minus 2. Then put y is equal to 0 here. Then we get 2x minus minus 3 into 0 is equal to 6. So we get here x is equal to 3. So now for this inequality, we have got two solutions. One is x is equal to 0, y is equal to minus 2. Another one is x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 0. Next step is we have to locate the points on the graph for all the three inequalities. So first let us consider the inequality one by one. First we have here 2x plus y, that is equal to 4. For this we have these points 0, 4 and 2, 0. So 0, 4 means we can consider this particular point 0, 4. Then next we have 2, 0 means this point you can consider 2, 0. So we have these two points. So join these two points. So you can get a straight line here. And here you have to use a solid straight line. Next we have the second equality statement, that is x plus y is equal to 3. For these we have two solutions 0, 3 and 3, 0. So 0, 3 means this one and 3, 0 means this point. So we got two points. So just join these two points. So we get a straight line again. So the line represents x plus y is equal to 3. Next, consider the third one. We have here 2x minus 3y is equal to 6. So for this, the points are 0, minus 2 and 3, 0. So 0, minus 2 is this point and 3, 0 is this point. So we have got two points. Join these two points by drawing a line. So this line represents 2x minus 3y is equal to 6. Now here we have to consider the inequalities and we have to check the true value or false value. Based on that, we need to shade the region. So first let us take the first inequality 2x plus y greater than or equal to 4. Here you take the origin point or you can take any point. So 0, 0 I am taking. So for that I got 0 greater than or equal to 4, that is false. So I have taken this particular point for this particular inequality, this particular straight line, and I got false. That means now I need to consider the opposite region, not this region. So this region I need to shade. For the inequality 2x plus y greater than or equal to 4. Next we have x plus y less than or equal to 3. Again for this also I am taking the origin as a point. So 0, 0 if I put, then I get 0 less than or equal to 3. That is true statement. So here I have taken the point 0, 0 and for that I got true. For this particular inequality, that is x plus y less than or equal to 3. That means I need to shade this area. So if the value is true means the you need to shade the region, that is 0, 0 point, that is this region you have to shade. And if the value is false means the opposite area you have to shade. Next we have 2x minus 3y less than or equal to 6. So here if I put x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0, then here I get 0 less than or equal to 6. This is also true here. So we have this region 2x minus 3y less than or equal to 6 and I got here true and I have taken the point 0, 0. That means this region I need to shade. So here we have three lines. See, for the inequality 2x plus y greater than or equal to 4, this area we have to shade. Then next x plus y less than or equal to 3, this area we have to shade. Then 2x minus 3y less than or equal to 6, for that we have to shade this area. So now the common area shared among all these three inequalities, this one. So this is the answer. This region is the answer for the 11th question. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.